What the fuck? Paul fucking McCartney? What the fuck?
Well, we live in a time where this can happen. When it comes to the fans of many bands, the lineup is as sacred as the Holy Grail. And if you lose an original member who was around since the beginning, the music would never be the same, especially if said member was the lead singer and songwriter. I mean, can you imagine Primus without Claypool, System of a Down without Surge, Weird Al without Weird Al? Sometimes if a band loses a singer, another member would just take over. Genesis and Pink Floyd both did this. Well, Phil Collins did eventually leave Genesis for good in the 90s, leaving the band to pick up Ray Wilson to replace him. We'll get to that album soon enough. Now, a lot of bands would just break up after losing a singer, and then probably come back years later with someone new. Which brings us to Sublime with Rome. We took this trip to Garden Grove. Smell like Lou Dog and Man, when I was a kid growing up in the 90s, sweet ska punk bands were the big shit on MTV for like 2 minutes. I totally dug the punk-infused, horn-infested, kinda reggae, kinda not music of bands like No Doubt, Mighty Mighty Boss Tones, and Real Big Fish, just to name a few. And one of my favorites was Sublime. Out of all of the dubby ska bands, there was no one that sounded like them. Their music was filled with punk, dub, reggae, hip-hop, and just plain fucking around. They're just one of those bands where each album is freaking fantastic. 40 Ounce to Freedom is an amazing debut. Robin the Hood has a lot of great bullshit. And their final album of new material, the self-titled Sublime, takes what's great about the first two and polishes it to perfection. Sadly, their lead singer and guitarist, Brad Noel, was taken from us too damn soon. He died of a heroin overdose while on tour. Sublime released a couple of compilation albums after this before calling it quits for good. It's my bed sheet covered with sand. Life's rolled across some dance balls, still the girls are dressed red. The surviving members then started a new band called the Long Beach Dub All Stars, who kicked some serious ass. They did the LBDA thing for a while, releasing 2 albums before breaking up. And that was it for a long time until they hooked up with Rome Ramirez, a young dude who was a big Sublime fan. They all jammed for a while and started playing shows under the Sublime name. Then they were sued. It turns out that original members Eric Wilson and Bud however you want to say it, we're never going to use the Sublime name again in respect to their fallen member, and because the copyright was in Brad's name. The case was eventually dismissed and they changed the name to Sublime with Rome. In July of 2011, they released their debut album, Yours Truly. Now, is Rome a worthy replacement? Let's check it out. Hell to the yes! This song is awesome. It's heavy, it's energetic, and I totally dig the horns. The band sounds like they haven't lost their touch, and Rome does a damn good job of sounding similar to Brad, while at the same time throwing his own unique spin on things. It's off to a pretty good start.
Track 2, man, only.
I stand my ground in stormy weather. Only is chill as hell. It has this tight summer groove and your average reggae beat. But that's not a bad thing.
It's short and sweet to the point to where it doesn't really get old. It's just the right length at only 2.5 minutes.
Hey man, it's track 3, Lovers Rock. The only thing she told
me about the sick side of the world is when she caught me cheating, she said she would never be my. Lovers Rock is a total bomb fest. It has this sweet island vibe and spacey sound effects going around. The lyrics are a little love songy, but it's okay to have a decent love song here and there.
This track, it's so close to the early Sublime stuff while throwing in a little bit of new. And I love the fucking saxophone towards the end. It'll make the most sober person feel stoned as hell. Excuse me. Track 5, My World.
Can you save me from myself? I don't think so. I'm my own worst enemy. My World is another punky ska track that totally brings me back to 96. Now I will say that the production quality of this album is sort of reminding me of Sublime's self-titled album. Not a bad thing. Now, the album so far is reminding me of the old days, but it hasn't blown my mind yet. But I do dig what's on here.
Track 6, Paper Cuts.
Supercuts is a short little punk song that rocks pretty hard. Now I could say that it's just a generic sounding punk song, but I like how it only clocks in at like 1:53, so it doesn't really take long enough to suck.
Track 7, man. PCH. We open up our eyes.
This is Sublime.
Sublime Rome!
Oh yeah. We'll be back after this.
Number 8, dude. Same old situation. If I could
just only ask of one more thing I'd want from you. Same old situation is a little boring. The music plays it safe with that same old reggae beat heard on most of this album. The old Sublime had a lot more variety and sporadic changes than this.
Sublime was wrong, motherfucker!
Take it or leave it.
She's got a knack for hurting me. Is it the word she says? The only thing that
it sounds
keeps
just like the last song.
Are her eyes in the morning? Well, I've packed.
Track 10, dude. You better listen.
This song
song isn't bad. I dig the female vocals that come in, and it has a pretty sweet solo. But it doesn't really break the mold all too much. It's just another track using that same old bouncy guitar riff.
Want to restore my sanity? Oh, baby, look at me. I'm a fool. I tear myself into for the.
Track 11, Spun.
I'm spun. Like a raisin in the sun.
Didn't it already play this song? I will say this. This guy doesn't play the guitar like a motherfucking right.
With all the love inside my head.
Track 12, dude. Can you feel it? Featuring Wiz Khalifa.
This is one of the better songs in a while. It's a stony song that totally makes me want to light up another dude. And I don't know much about Wiz Khalifa, but his verse about smoking the weed is a nice change of pace on the album compared to all the lovey lovey songs. Too bad it's the last fucking track!
Hit it once, you won't believe this.
This album is okay. The first half is really good, bringing back nostalgic feelings of when ska was a prominent force on the radio. But around the second half, things start to get a little boring. Breakup songs, love songs, and hardly breaking away from the old tried and true reggae riffs. Rome does a good job, his voice is pretty good, and it fits the old Sublime vibe really well. His writing style is a little boring compared to that of Brad Noel.
Man, it's a lot deeper than that. Love, why you bring me down? Oh, love, bring me down.
Anyway, Brad would write songs about running from the police, getting into trouble, and a lot of songs about drugs. Rome sort of just plays it safe. Hell, the whole album plays it safe. But that doesn't ruin the album at all to me. There's a lot of good songs and some weird sounds here and there, but it doesn't match a lot of the charm, energy, and in-your-faceness of the old Sublime.
Sublime with Rome! Motherfucker!
I know that, but really though, did they really need to call it Sublime? I mean, they could have called the band anything, and I'd look at it like an homage to the old stuff, rather than looking at it like, hey, we're back, kinda.
Here you go, motherfucker.
What the fuck is this?
Motherfucker!